Good afternoon to all teachers and educators who joined us today. We see that more teachers are joining us, so we'll be waiting for 2 more minutes before we begin. Thank you for waiting. Good afternoon to all the teachers. We see that more teachers are joining today's session, so we'll be waiting for a few more minutes before we start the session. Meanwhile, you can see that on the Google chat, a Google form link has been shared. Kindly fill in your basic details to mark the attendance. Good afternoon, all teachers.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
There's a Google form link shared on the chat. Kindly open the link and fill in your basic details to mark your attendance. Good afternoon, everyone. To those who just joined, kindly check your Google message chat. A Google form link has been shared. Kindly open that Google form link and fill in your details to mark your attendance. Those who have already filled it, ignore it. We'll be strictly starting the session within 1 minute. Once again, a very good afternoon to all the educators and teachers who joined us here today. We will now begin the session. For those of you who just joined in, there's a Google form link shared on your Google chat. Kindly open the Google form link and fill in your basic details to mark your attendance. Good afternoon, all teachers and educators. I'm Praveena. I welcome you all on behalf of Sri Aurobindo Society and Project Inclusion. In today's session, we'll be discussing about what exactly Project Inclusion is, its aim, what is it working towards, and how can we as teachers and educators be a part of this mission. Before we begin, I would like to convey three things. One, if during the session, at any point of time, if you have any questions, kindly make a note of it. We will address your questions towards the end of the session. Second thing, during the session, until we close the session for today, before we open the round for questions, kindly keep your calls on mute in order to avoid any disturbance. Third thing, if by any chance, if you get disconnected, you can always join back. And if the speaker, that is myself, get disconnected, the speaker shall join back within 2 minutes. There is nothing to worry. Having said that, let us now begin today's session. Before we go into the what and how we shall be a part of this project inclusion, let's look at why inclusive education is the need of the hour. If we look at the general statistics in India currently, according to a census in 2011, it is said that there's approximately 26.8 million individuals with disabilities in India. According to another census by UNESCO in 2019, it is said that about 7.8 million children with disabilities are in India who are under the age of 19 years. These numbers are alarming. But at the same time, it is said that about 1/4 of the complete CWD population between the ages of 5 to 19 do not attend any educational institutions. Furthermore, It's very alarming to know that below the age of 5 years of age, about 3/4 of the children are not able to attend any educational institutions when they're children with disabilities. Not just the general nature of disabilities, when you look at the specific nature of disabilities that affect the learning problems in children, it is said that currently about nearly one in every 12 Indian children have some sort of specific learning disability. About 1.7 to 2 million children are being identified in India along this range of the autism spectrum disorder. As you can see these numbers clearly show the disparity. If there are these many number of children who are unable to get access to education, what is our role? What shall we do to increase or improve this situation? How can we as educators be a part of this? Let us discuss it in the next slide. What do we even need to make this situation better? First thing, as you all know, there needs to be a better connection between the teachers and the special educators. Second thing, we need an experienced team of experts who are supporting teachers and thereby also the children. Third, in addition to the support with teachers, we also need accessibility till the last mile, not just ensuring that some part of the population is getting this benefit. And as you know, India is quite a diverse nation. We have a lot of languages available. So we also need a multilingual scalable technology. And it's not just we, the students, teachers, and the special educators. There is a need for the government to be a part of this to ensure that there is an effective execution. Lastly, it's not okay, the students shall be supported by the teachers, but who will support the teachers? The teachers need support in terms of professional courses for upskilling and training of the teachers and a strong hand-holding support system. Lastly, as you all know, teachers alone cannot make this journey a success. There is a need for increased parent participation. This is where project inclusion comes in. Through the project inclusion, we are addressing all these concerns. How and why and how shall you be a part of this? We'll be discussing it further in the next slides. How did project inclusion come into place? Project inclusion initially began in the year 2016. Initially, when it began with an aim to create an inclusive learning environment with a zero rejection policy of any children who's a part of the school environment. Till date, ever since its launch, there's been its presence in more than 14 states and union territories. Initially, when we began with this project inclusion, we started training the teachers on this. A lot of teachers said that, you know, we don't have any such children with disabilities in our classroom. But when those same teachers were trained, they were sensitized, the same very teachers were able to identify potential of neurodevelopmental disorders, and out of those same students that teachers screened, more and more cases for psychometric assessment started to come up. In this format, till date, more than 20,000 teachers have been oriented, and more than out of these teachers' orientations, these very same teachers have identified and screened more than 18,000 students. And out of these very same 18,000 students, more than 6,600 cases of NDD came up. So this just shows that with the right training and awareness, a lot more children with learning difficulties could be identified and benefited in the classroom environment. Now, how is Sri Aurobindo Society and Project Inclusion doing this in the current scenario? Initially, when it began in 2016, it began by an offline mode. After COVID pandemic, the platform shifted from offline to a complete online mode via an app. Now, all of us can get access to this project via this app in a very easy format. We shall discuss further on how we shall get access to this app and how we shall benefit. Let's just look at an overview. Firstly, as teachers, we are going to go through stages in this app. The first stage, the phase one, is called the sensitization phase. In this phase, all the teachers will get access to one of the course that targets learning difficulties of the children. You all might relate to this. In our classrooms, when we sit down, not all students learn in the same pace. So this course will help us better understand children across learning needs, thereby gain the necessary awareness on different neurodevelopmental disorders. Phase two. Once you get the awareness and understanding in the phase one, you shall now move to phase two, in which you shall begin to identify students. Once when you spot that there is any student in your classroom who is having a probable case of learning difficulty or neurodevelopmental disorder, you can screen these children via app in the phase two. Phase three, once you finish the screening and identify the children, now what? How are you as an educator going to help the student? How are you as an educator at the same time help the child with the NDD as well as your entire classroom and make it an inclusive classroom? That is where the phase three comes in. These three phases are just an overview of how it shall look like. We shall now go into each details of each of the phases. If you have any questions at any point of time, please feel free to take a note and we shall address these questions towards the end. Let us now go into the details of phase one. As we discussed, it's about the sensitization and awareness. In this phase, you'll get access to one course. We shall now look into the details of that course. The course name would be called Learning Difficulties, Understanding and Management Level 1. This course will consist of Introduction to Inclusive Education Policies, as well as increase your understanding on different learning disabilities, neurodevelopmental disorders, etc. It will also help you get a brief overview of the management strategies. This course is divided into 17 modules. All these 17 modules will cover each different topic under the learning difficulties. Each of the module has approximately 4 videos. Now, I would like to tell you that each of this video is hardly in a 2 to maximum 3 minute format that you can view. And for those of you who is not comfortable with the visual mode or who wants to have an extra hand and get the reading material, that is also available. It's important to, I would like to convey to you that this course is available in multiple languages, not just English. It's also available in Hindi and other regional languages that you can always get access to. At the end of each module, as teachers, you all know the benefit and the factor of feel-good learning. So all of us, towards the end of the course, towards the end of each module, you will have an assessment. This assessment is just in a simple MCQ format, multiple choice questions that you should answer. And once you successfully complete the assessments of each modules and course, you shall get a course completion certificate. How this course shall look like and what are the other courses available to you, you shall look at it in the next slide. Now, as you once register on the app and open this app, you'll see different courses, out of which, as I discussed, in phase one, you'll only get access to the first course, which is learning difficulties. You can click on that green button called launch and launch this course. Here, I would like to convey that only after you finish the first course and complete all the necessary things in the first course, you'll gain access to the rest of the courses. Let us now have a look at how the course is going to look like with the help of a small video. As I said, it's available in a video format, so make sure the audio on your devices is set to maximum and hear it effectively. I shall now be playing the video. If in case due to any reason you're unable to hear that video, kindly drop a message on the chat.
डिसलेक्सिया स्थिति को समझना ए बी सी डी ई एफ जी एच आई जे के एल एम एन ओ पी क्यू आर एस टी यू वी डब्ल्यू एक्स वाई जेड आप सोच रहे होंगे कि हम इस स्तर पर पहुंचकर फिर से अक्षर सीखना क्यों शुरू कर रहे हैं? आपके लिए ये सरल अक्षर है। इन 26 अक्षरों के भीतर आप स्वर और व्यंजन की पहचान करने में सक्षम हो सकते हैं। अब अगर हम ये कहें कि ऐसा कर पाना सभी के लिए संभव नहीं है, तो जोया से मिलिए। जोया 6 वर्ष की है और उसे अक्षर वैसे नहीं दिखते जैसे हम और आप देखते हैं। उसे बस कुछ नाचती तैरती आकृतियां ही दिखती हैं। जोया के लिए अक्षरों को उनकी ध्वनियों से जोड़ना और फिर उन ध्वनियों का शब्दों के साथ सम्मिश्रित करना बेहद कठिन काम है, क्योंकि वो शब्दों का उच्चारण नहीं कर सकती और न ही उनकी आवाज पहचान सकती है, इसलिए वो इसका अर्थ भी नहीं समझ पाती है। तो जोया की समस्या क्या है? जोया की स्थिति को डिसलेक्सिया कहते हैं। डिसलेक्सिया एक भाषा आधारित अधिगम अक्षमता है। इस स्थिति का सामना करने वाले छात्रों को भाषा की व्याख्या और प्रसंस्करण दोबारा प्रयोग करने में चुनौतियों का सामना करना पड़ता है। ये स्थिति किसी व्यक्ति की पढ़ने, वर्तने, लिखने और बोलने की क्षमता को प्रभावित करती है। हालांकि इन छात्रों के पास एक सामान्य दृष्टि होने पर और अपने साथियों की तरह ही होशियार होने के बावजूद भी वे अपने शैक्षणिक जीवन में संघर्ष करते हैं। यहाँ डिसलेक्सिक छात्र के लिए एक ऐसे शिक्षक की आवश्यकता है जो उसके व्यक्तिगत सीखने के अनुकूल तरीके से पढ़ा सके। वीडियो की इस श्रृंखला में हम डिसलेक्सिया वाले छात्रों के लिए कुछ शिक्षण रणनीतियों के बारे में जानेंगे। इससे पहले कि हम उन सत्रों को आरंभ करें, हमारे लिए ये जानना महत्वपूर्ण है कि एक सहायक शिक्षण वातावरण कक्षा को डिसलेक्सिया के अनुकूल बनाने में बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाता है। एक शिक्षक की विशिष्ट कठिनाइयों के प्रति समझ और एक छात्र के कक्षा में प्रदर्शन को प्रभावित कर पाने की जानकारी उस शिक्षक के लिए योजना बनाने और व्याख्या के साथ आगे बढ़ने का एक खाका तैयार करता है। अगले सत्र से हम उन रणनीतियों को सीखना शुरू करेंगे जिन्हें इस परिस्थिति वाले छात्रों को पढ़ाने के लिए लागू किया जा सकता है। हमसे जुड़े रहें। डिसलेक्सिया।
As you can see, this is only one video that is currently we showed you in a Hindi language. As I understand, this today's session contains most of the teachers from the Hyderabad region. So I would like to convey to you that it's not only in Hindi, the same video and the complete course is also available in English and also Telugu. You can choose during the time of the registration on the app which language is more comfortable you and avail the course in that format. As I said, it's not just in the video format. For those teachers who also want to have a reading of the entire material, entire script that you saw or heard in the video, the content is also available to you in a readable format in this way. Having said that, we would like
dyslexia. Sthiti ko samajhna. A B.
Apologies for that. So, having said that, we would like to convey to you that your efforts in completing this course will be rightly rewarded. Firstly, I would like to convey to you in what cases and what is the criteria for you to get your certificate of finishing this course. Firstly, upon completion of each module, the teacher will get a module assessment. As I said, this is a simple multiple choice question. And once you finish that module assessment with at least 50% of right answers, you'll get a module assessment. Similarly, once you finish all the 17 modules, you will get a entire 17 modules ka different 17 certificates. And after you finish the entire 17 modules, you'll get one course assessment. This course assessment will have questions from the entire course, again in the multiple choice format. Once you finish this final assessment with at least a minimum 60% score, you will be eligible for the course completion certificate. Some teachers and some learners are always exceptional, so that if you manage to get above 75% of the score, we acknowledge your efforts through a special Achiever E-certificate that you shall get. Here, I would like to convey to you that though the number might seem like 17 modules, as we discussed, it's barely 2 to 3 minute videos that you can always skim and understand better, available in audio and visual. Hardly, if you can could give only 30 minutes a day, ideally the entire course will be completed in 7 to maximum 10 days, not more than that. So I urge you all to once again take a positive outlook towards this and have a successful journey on this course. Before we move further, I would like to show you an example of how your course certificate shall look like once you finish this course. So this is how your certificate shall look like. In the name section, you shall have your own name when you finish the course, followed by your region, school, and what is the date of such completion with right credentials and everything. This concludes the detailed discussion of the phase one of the app, which is your understanding and sensitization. Now, let us move on further to phase two. Phase two, as we discussed, is about the identification of potential students. In phase one, we got an understanding of how the learning difficulties work. With that understanding, we shall now proceed to phase two, to identify the potential student. Hello, sir. Could you please mute your audio? So how will we do this screening is through the screening forms available to you on the app. We shall now go into the details of what are the screening forms, how to get access to it. I'll first give you an overview. So in the screening stage, once you finish the course, there are three forms. First form is called screening one form. Now you might identify a child and you feel like this child might potentially have a neurodevelopmental disorder, but is it true or not? So your screening one form is for that, in order to rule out if the child is or is not having any potential NDD or any other disability. As teachers, you all might relate, it's not just the flaws of the student you need to be aware of. You also need to know the child's personality and the child's strength to work with the child. So your second form, the trailer form, is for that, wherein you get to have a deeper understanding of the student by understanding their personality, strengths and all. How? Again, through a form which I shall show you further. Third form is advanced screening form. The child's understanding and learning difficulties in each of the domains, you shall get an understanding. Let's say if the child is in the academic domain, you can get a more advanced understanding of that in the third form. So one thing I repeat, your screening phase two, once you finish the entire course, only then you will be able to get access to screening. And in screening, you have three forms. You need to fill these three forms in order to complete the screening of a student. Now you might wonder, let's say my child is in third grade, or if the child is in sixth grade, will it be class specific? My answer is yes. In the Project Inclusion app, your entire screening forms are available in a grade specific format. For foundation, preparatory, middle, and secondary, these four categories, once you choose the grade of the child, the respective category questionnaires and screenings will be available to you. Now, you all might be wondering, we are talking of screening form, but how is it, what is it, and all. So let us have a simple look at how it shall look like. As you can see here, your screening forms will look like this. In simple, easy to understand language, again, available in different regional languages with a simple yes or no options. If the child is falling into the yes category, you might just answer it as yes. And respectively, if the child is not showing that sign, you answer. Similarly, once you finish all those questions, the respective screening forms report will appear to you. You can proceed to the next session. next section. I would like to convey that only after you finish the first form, your second form will open to you, and only once you finish the second form, the third form will open to you, and you can always save your responses of that so far. Let us now have a look at how the screening report shall look like once you enter the details. So as you can see, once you enter the student details, that is the name, which grade, what is the parent's name, any number of that child who can be contacted. Once you enter those details, all those details will be saved and they will be shown to you. Once you finish the screening one form, all those responses will be shared and a report on the same will be generated. Similarly for the advanced screening. Ultimately, once you finish these three forms, the entire result of the child across it, like if the child is falling into any potential category, which you can find out through the screening form, one form that will be available to you. The second aspect of what is the child's strength, even that will be available to you in the form of a report. And third thing, what is the in-depth? Is the child suffering more in academic, more in the cognitive, or more in the behavioral domain? Even that will be available to you in a detailed report format on the app itself. Once you get an access to this app, it concludes your phase two screening. Here, I would like to specify to you that as of now, the minimum number of students all the teachers will screen is 5 students. That is, once you finish the course, all teachers are requested to at least finish a minimum number of 5 students for screening. There is no maximum number of students. And only those students, yes, Sonia ma'am, we'll address your questions towards the end of the session, and I'll get to that part of the presentation as well. So once you gain access to the report, now you can gain access to the phase three, which is intervention. Now, what is intervention about? Let's go into the details of that. Intervention, as I said, it's about how in detail as teachers we shall work with the students in the classroom environment. We shall get into the overview of it, how phase three will work like in the next slide. Now, once you finish the screening of the 5 students, all of you are encouraged to attend a session similar to this, wherein we will detail you how the phase three is going to be like. But an overview to give you right now, teachers, out of those 5 students that you did screening of, you can pick one child to work with. That one child you can start working with the help of a mentor that will be up to you. Here, I would like to tell all of you that once you start your registration on this app, project inclusion will be there with you throughout the journey. Similarly, in the phase three stage, each of the teacher will be mapped to one mentor from the project inclusion team. With the help of that mentor, you can develop an education plan and work with that education plan in the classroom with that student in a way that it doesn't cause any incoherence with the rest of the classroom. After which, once you start working with the child, it's not a one-day process, as you all know. No change happens one day. So once you start working with the child, after 3 months or after 6 months, the success story of you as a teacher with that child and the child's success story can be posted post-intervention. Now let us have a look at how the intervention shall look like on the app, because everything will be doing through the app. To avoid any further confusion, we shall have a sample look at how it shall look like on the app. As you can look here, let's say the intervention plan is in the reading area. The child is unable to read properly or committing a lot of mistakes, or there's a lot of confusion. The child is unable to read. There's a detailed plan that you can see in terms of what is the concern, what is the specific goal for the child for the next 3 months, what is the accommodations you can make in the classroom, and what are the steps that you can take to teach that particular child. As we discussed earlier, teachers support students, but who shall support teachers? That is where intervention plan comes in, wherein you can get access to the intervention plan. You can always discuss this with your mentor and get to work with the child. I would like to convey here that it's not just one course that is available to you. Once you finish till the intervention and once you finish all the necessary steps in each of the course, the rest of the courses as well will be available to you. We shall show you a brief overview of those courses that will be available to you on the app in the next slide. As you can see here, we'll be only doing the first course initially, which is the learning difficulties, understanding and management. Eventually, process of learning, reading, writing, mathematics, all such courses, working on behavior as well will be gradually available to you on the app. Here, I would like to clarify that only after you fulfill the requirements of each of the courses, the other courses will be accessed to you. And then you can straight away launch that and understand it. Now, until now, we received a lot of information on how the entire process shall go on, like how shall we have and visualize how this entire process work, how will the intervention plan work, which area of the child are we targeting, is this effective? In order to address all these questions, let us now look at a video to understand how the overall intervention plan shall work. Hope that shall be helpful to all of us. I'll now be playing the video. So once again, I request all the teachers to set your audio to maximum.
Chapter 1, Brain and Learning. Through the course of Project Inclusion in Phase 1, you have studied in detail about neurodevelopmental disorders, specific learning disability, autism, and intellectual disability, along with the academic challenges faced by children with each of these conditions. Through this phase, we will understand what the reasons are for their academic challenges and how, with strategies, we can work towards inclusion. A school's primary focus is academic learning. And in a classroom, there will be different kinds of learners. For some children, learning academic concepts is easy and effortless. Some are average learners, while others face challenges, especially children with disabilities. Why are there differences in learning? For this, we need to understand where and how learning happens. Where does learning take place? The obvious answer to the above question is the brain, and it is important for us to know a little about how the brain is involved in learning. Neurodevelopmental disorders are caused by impairments in the growth and development of the brain. Due to these impairments, learning gets affected and becomes a challenge for such children. A number of specific parts of the brain play a role in reading, writing, and maths, which are the core fundamentals of education. In order to be effective teachers and parents, we must understand how the brain influences the development of these skills. Let's take an example of the areas for reading in the brain. Here is the image of the brain, which shows the cortex part. It is made up of lobes. When we read a word like book, it activates the occipital lobes of our brain like any other visual stimuli. This visual area instantly analyzes the feature of the word and then moves to the part of the brain for word analysis and sound symbol connection, where the word book will be analyzed into sound, which is b-u-k. Again, the temporal lobe, as we can see, will help promote language comprehension and also reading comprehension. As we can see here, that different areas of the brain are involved in writing as well as performing mathematical calculations.
as you can see in the video, most of us have some primary understanding of how this all works. But how is it actually affecting our students, our classroom, when we actually sit in a classroom? I hope this video helped you get an overview. I would like to say here that by gaining such deep understanding of each learning profile of the student, we shall step into a new way of managing a classroom. And herein, I would like to say that this is not just a one-time thing. We shall be following it through a series of steps, and PI team, project inclusion team, will be helping you and assisting you throughout all these three phases. Now, let us help and let us have a look at your overall journey. I hope this can help you visualize how your overall journey right from today to the next few days will look like. So today we shall begin with getting an understanding of how the app is working. We shall download the app. We shall register the app, register ourselves on the app. Once you register, over the next few days, you shall get an access to the course. Once you finish the course, as we discussed, we'll have these three screening forms. And once you finish the screening one, profiler, and advanced screening form, you can start working on your intervention. And once you pick a child to work with, over the 6 months, as we discussed, we shall publish your story. And you can also showcase your effort as a teacher and grow as a role model teacher and a role model champion school. Here, your success stories, I would like to say that are not just for, as you all know, for not just at a school level or at an individual level, but in order to create a better inclusive environment in each and every school. In this format, in a similar way, let us look at how project inclusion and teachers have worked together to create an impact. Let us look at it in the next slide. More than 3 lakh teachers so far were oriented in this program. More than 1,36,000 teachers, and more numbers are growing as we speak. Teachers are already registered on the Project Inclusion app. And despite of their busy schedule, more than 44,000 teachers have already finished the LMS course out of these numbers. And the numbers keep increasing as we speak. There's been more than 1 lakh registrations and more than 32 MOUs signed with state governments and UTs, union territories. Now, this is not just an impact story that I'm sharing. I would like to say that this is also hope for all the teachers, that all of us aspire for change, but we as teachers, as educators, we also need the support of systems to make that possible. What are the benefits of such program? What are the benefits of such impact? We shall have a brief overlook. First thing, because of this program, because of this collaboration between a team of educators and teachers and also a project, is that we are able to provide comprehensive teacher training for teachers, special educators, and ensure the optimum utilization of resources. And not just this, we are also bringing parents into the picture and increasing the parent participation, and also making sure that this is not a effort that is reaching only urban space or so on, but it's going to the last mile access. We are educating and orienting different education officers. We are collaborating with, we are developing personalized interventions for each of the child. As I said earlier, in the beginning, we learned that there's an end systematic change. The actual social inclusion of now coming to the part where, as coordinators, I understand there's a few coordinators for each region and each school shall have a between the teachers and the team. We shall now briefly look what are your, as coordinators, what are your roles and responsibilities, and how shall we stay connected. So coming to the coordinator's duties, first thing, it's a level of, at the level of role. As coordinators, you shall help all the teachers download and register and enroll on the app. And second level, at an implementation level, at the phase one level, you shall encourage teachers and ensure that all teachers have completed the phase one, which is the course, within 8 to 10 days. And once that is done, you can review the progress report that is shared by Sri Aurobindo Society and provided the needed support to whichever teachers who are unable to complete the course. Second thing, at a phase two level, the students, once the students are screened, ensuring that at least 5 students are screened by all the teachers. And at a third level, ensure that everyone who finished the phase two are attending the phase three sessions. Furthermore, at the level of monitoring evaluation, coordinators can help us support the PI team by encouraging teachers to send in their testimonials, to send in their feedback, and also share your success stories so we can share it with the world. Secondly, you can also encourage the teachers to attend certain sessions, doubt clearing sessions, weekly sessions, to help stay connected and improve our coordination. Third thing, as we discussed, at least to ensure that 5 students are screened. Lastly, in terms of communication and support, this is a technological platform overall. So we might face some or the other issue. Although all teachers will get access to a WhatsApp chat support number, as coordinators, if there's any major technical support issues or challenges faced by your teachers, you can always address it to the PI team directly. And you can take up the leadership to offer guidance and support teachers regarding the program activities and keep encouraging the teachers to attend the phase three sessions whenever they are there and get your doubts clarified. And now coming to the question of, is there any WhatsApp group for these coordinators? I will now be sharing you a QR code to join this. The link and the QR code access will also be shared to you via the chat. You can always go through, but now I'll be sharing you. The coordinators on this meeting can now take a picture of this or directly scan this WhatsApp group link. Only the coordinators. You can directly scan this and join that WhatsApp group. If I skip the slide, there's nothing to worry. The same will also be shared with you on the Google chat and pinned so that you can take that link access and join the group. Furthermore, like I said, all the teachers can also get access to a continuous WhatsApp chat support number during the working hours. I'll be sharing also that number. I request all teachers to make a note of this number and the mail ID in case of any issue. You're stuck at the time of registration, stuck while using the app, or have any questions while using this app. You can always send your query or take a screenshot of your issue and share it via this WhatsApp chat support number. Here, I would like to specify.
Hello. Hello. Praveena?
Yes, ma'am.
I would like you to display the WhatsApp QR code for a little more time so okay, that everybody ma'am. Knows.
I'll get back.
And we are also sharing the link. If somebody is not able to scan, they can use the link and join.
Yes, ma'am.
Monday, Wednesday morning, Tuesday evening, Malay Potu,
like 32. Ma'am?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. Kindly mute your audio. Right. Once again, I'm sharing the QR code for all the coordinators to join the WhatsApp group. You can take a photo or directly scan it to join. Or if in case you miss it, we are also sharing you the link via the same meeting chat. You can click on that link and join the WhatsApp group. Yes, ma'am. So this number again is for all the teachers who have any queries or issues. If you in between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. from Monday to Friday, this number shall be active and we shall be addressing any queries that you may have. You can always feel free to reach out on this number in this specific time and expect a response. If in any case you are unable to and have a further queries to share, you can contact us via the following mail. Kindly make a note of this number. We'll also be sharing this number via the Google Meet chat. Kindly save it. Hope you all took a note of the respective numbers. I will shortly sharing you also the QR code to scan and install the Project Inclusion app. You can take a picture of it or directly scan it to download the Project Inclusion app. If you are more comfortable on a desktop version, the desktop link for the same will also be shared. And the iOS users also, the means to download it and use it will be shared. Yes, ma'am, the link for iOS users will be shared. The desktop version link will be shared. The message that is shared right now on the chat is to save the WhatsApp chat support number. And as you can see, this is the web link for iOS users. You can save that link in order to get access to the app. All the iOS users, kindly make a note of this link. For all the Android users, I'll now be sharing a QR code as well. All the Android users can take a picture or directly scan this QR code to download this app. I hope you all can see the QR code right now. Once again, I repeat, all the iOS or desktop users can join through the web link. The web link has also been shared on chat. Kindly save that link. We'll give you 1 minute right now to help you scan this and download the Project Inclusion app. I request all teachers to take a note of this QR code and download this app. As you make a note of this, I would like to once again tell you that the Project Inclusion team will be there with you throughout the journey. Let us have a look at our regular support, how we shall connect on a weekly basis in the next slide. So as you can see here, there would be weekly doubt clearing sessions from Monday to Friday at 4 p.m. Be it for you to get any concept clarified or to give any teachers feedback or to give or receive any support from your fellow teachers or build a system of community you have, you can get and attend these doubt clearing sessions. And if you need any expert support as well. For all those teachers who are saying that they've already finished the course, I suppose you've already moved to the screening version. And all those teachers who have already finished this screening of 5 students, you can now start working with the children. You can pick any one child out of those 5 students that you screened, and you can start the intervention plan. Meanwhile, sure, sir, Shikhar, sir, I will show you the benefits of this program page once again. Meanwhile, if any other teachers, we have 4 minutes. If you have any questions so far about this session, you can always go ahead and ask.
Ma'am, this is Jyotsna from Hyderabad region, KV Tirumalagiri. Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am. Actually, we were supposed to, in Hyderabad region, we were supposed to complete it by August 4th. And we have completed, most of us have completed. The modules were completed, got the certificates, and also screening of 5 students. I think most of the teachers in Hyderabad must have done. Now coming to, in your software, I feel that I think some modification has to be done, because some students are not able to talk at all. No speech. For them, there is no, I mean, nothing is given or other things. So that student, maybe he just copies as a picture, he copies from the board, but speech is zero. Now, what to do for such students? Not at all able to speak at all. There are, at least in Tirumalagiri, KV Tirumalagiri, where I'm teaching, I think per class, I think one student, I have taken 5 students. Of those, 3 students, speech is absolutely zero. And naturally, speech is not there, then we have problem. How do we train them?
Hello. Praveena, I would like to take the question.
Sure, ma'am.
Okay. Hello, ma'am. Good evening. I'm Rashmi, senior special educator from Sri Aurobindo Society. Okay. Actually, you didn't get anything regarding the speech in the app, in the intervention program for speech, because we are dealing with the NDD only, that is the neurodevelopmental disorders. So we can say the hidden disabilities in general term, that the disabilities which are not visible. So we are actually, we have given the intervention plan right now for autistic children or for the learning disability, ASD, and cognition. Okay, that is the mild ID children. As far as the speech is concerned, there can be many reasons. Maybe the child's speech, the entire, you can say the thing is affected. So that can be a reason. Another reason can be that the child's hearing is affected. If the child is not hearing, then at the same time, he will not have language development. So his speech will also be delayed and his speech will be affected. So when we have such children, ma'am, we should go for visual teachings. We should make it, because the child will not be able to give us oral responses. So the responses always has to be written form. Even when the child is taking, participating in class activities, make sure you are giving the, if the child is able to hear also, then also support your instructions with some visuals or written instructions. That will help the child to understand the things better. At the same time, take the written responses. Even you can encourage child to have some, you can say such answers. Suppose true, false, you are taking a class of where the child has to answer only true and false. You can have a card of true and false. You can give that child. The child can say, okay, this is true, this is false. Because the entire thing has to be done. The assessment is done with the only with the help of speech therapist. Speech and language therapist can only do that assessment. We special educators also don't intervene in that, because that is not our part. And we also don't want the teachers to do, because we are not trained for that. So when we are not trained, we are not going to do any good to the child. So what we can do, we can, what we say as in our special education, we say alternate communication methods, which is not verbal. So we can train the child for such communication methods, which is not, suppose one of those, if we know, everybody knows sign language is there. Apart from sign language, you can use some cards, like things are there in which the general, all the things are written, going to the toilet or whatever the child want, everything is there. The child can sew, or you can provide a sort notepad to the child where he can write and sew you if the child is able to write. So apart from that, ma'am, if you have some specific concern, you can join any day doubt clearing session. We all are there and we will help you there.
That's what, thank you so much, ma'am. That's what I wanted to tell you, that we are not trained in such, speech therapist. We are not speech therapists. So
yes, actually.
We can show little improvement in the form of, sign language or whatever it is.
Yeah.
So you want us to take only the one having this and the other problems, like those who are academically poor?
No.
You want to take up those cases?
You must take those cases, but you should not ignore these children also. Fortunately, right now in our team only, we have a very senior special educator who is trained in this hearing impairment. So he can guide us. So one day I'll keep a session with him and I would like you all to join. Okay, so that you can take some guidance from him. He is quite senior. He has around 35 years of experience. So he will be able to give you even more insight about how we can help in the classroom setting. See, ma'am, we all know they require special speech therapist. Okay, we all know that. But apart from that, what we can do as a teacher, that we need to learn. So one of those things is alternate communication methods, which can be written form, which can be sought. You can say nowadays you have those texts that even they type, and if they have the facilities, then if you are typing and the speech is coming out, so many tabs and all are there. So that is of course technology based, but within the classroom, written every response can be taken. Some other alternates method can be used, and we'll try very soon to keep a session with sir, and we'll connect with you all.
The thing was, when we are taking that test, so it is showing, it is giving the review as he appears to be a normal child with this little more effort. I think it is showing like that. So I thought it better address that.
No. Yes, ma'am, you correctly, because the app is based like that only. Now we are dealing majorly. The first screening, the screening is in three part. You have done the screening, so you are aware of it. First screening, we are dealing with other disabilities also. But when we are coming to the advanced screening, we are talking about only the 4-5 domains are there. Academic is there, behavior, communication. Yeah. And communication, we don't talk about speech. We talk about communication skills.
Yes. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
But still, you will get some ideas from the communication skills.
Yeah, that's what, because I don't know how to, we are doing, but only through sign language, not much improvement.
No, not possible, not possible. You can join any day doubt clearing session, ma'am, because that is 1 hour session again, where you can put up the concerns, means the specific, this is the part we are facing the problem, this is the part we are facing the problem, and we can give you the solution for that.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for reaching. Ma'am, there is one request, since you said that most of the teachers have done the course, now please start working with the children. And when you work with the children, please take some videos or photos and please share with us as your success story that yes, because you have done the course, so sensitization must have increased. So as a result, your perspective towards the child or your the way we look at the children, it changes a lot. So how it helped you and how you are able to do the intervention in the classroom, please bring it to us. It is a great motivation for us also. Thank you so much, ma'am. Any other teacher is having any other concern?
Madam, is there any time frame to complete all modules? Because already we completed 17 modules. So next.
No, since you have already done the 17 modules, there is a time frame for that only. And when you must have seen some courses in the third phase, okay, reading, writing, mathematics and all, that is for just to enhance your knowledge. Suppose if you are a maths teacher, we can't bound you to do the reading course. But it's your choice if you want to learn how the reading is developed in a child, then you can do that course also. It is open, and that is why you can do it, any one of the courses. One course we definitely tell every teacher to do, that is brain and learning, so that you understand how learning takes place. And this helps you to engage the child. This helps you to do accommodations in the classroom.
Thank you, madam. And do we need to submit any kind of proof, like all teachers completed? Do we need to submit anything?
We have the proof. We have the list. So hopefully, when you are doing, so make sure that the children, it's not only on the paper, sir, it's implemented in the classroom. That is what we need, that the children inclusivity, what we are talking about, it should reach the every classroom of the country.
Okay, automatically you will get to know because everyone is submitting through online. So yes, you will get the, yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.
Coming to the question of intervention, you can for the moment select only one child to work with, and later on you can take more children to work with.
Madam, excuse me. I am, yes, Radha, ma'am, from KV Khammam. I have done half of the modules, ma'am, but then I forgot the password and my certificates are there in that link only. So if I log in now, will I get all those certificates back?
Yes, ma'am. You can log in. If you have forgotten the password, you can log in using the OTP.
Okay.
Still, if you face any problem, you can connect with us on our WhatsApp support number so that we can get you logged in. And your certificates are such that you can download, you can say anytime. Okay. Mm-hmm. Whenever you feel like that, yes, I need the certificate, you can generate it. Okay. Okay, ma'am.
Right. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Mayank sir, there is no specific time frame for completing the intervention plan. It might begin, as you know, it's not a one day journey or a 1 week we want to bring the change. So it can continue to go on for a few days, like 3 months or 6 months. There is no time to complete intervention, but for beginning intervention, all those teachers who completed the screening, we encourage you to all start working on the intervention. Pick a child to work with and you can start. If there's any questions of any other teachers, you can always join.
Ma'am, can I interrupt you? Yes, ma'am, actually last December, I did the course. I have the certificates of all the 17 plus one, the final certificate. So I can go straight into screening.
Yes, ma'am. Now that you've finished all the 17 modules, now that you can you will find access, your screening option will now be open. You can directly go ahead with the screening.
Okay.
Furthermore, if any of the teachers have any more questions, please feel free to join the doubt clearing session that is conducted.
You were talking about doubt session, doubt clarification session,
yes,
from Monday,
yes,
to Friday.
Yes.
Are we going to have a session or such, or is it going to be one-to-one? Like if I have a doubt,
any number of teachers can join in. The questions will be addressed one-to-one. If you have a question, it will be directly addressed. And once your questions are clarified, you can feel free to go on with your daily activities. But whoever has a question, you can join the doubt clearing session.
Actually, you know, this is the exam season for us. Next week or this week, towards the end of this week, our exams begin.
Okay, ma'am.
So we will definitely get busy with the evaluation and submission and all this. Can we start a little after that? Because you need to have a peace, you know, calm mind also to take up anything.
Right. Rashmi, ma'am, would you like to take up this question?
Hello. Ma'am, you can take your time, but I'll suggest that if you take one child a day, since you have observed the child for more than a half year, because half yearly exams are going to begin. So half of the year you have observed the child, you can do the screening. Intervention, as far as the intervention is concerned, of course, when you start teaching again, because right now every school is having the examination. So once, yes, the examinations, yes, are over, again the classes begins, then you can start the intervention part. For the screening, you have to take out, suppose one day you can take out 15, 20 minutes also, you can do a screening of a child. Otherwise, of course, you can wait. That is an option. But since you have observed the child for such a long time, I don't think there will be a big problem when you are answering the questions, because they are in yes and no format only. Okay, so yes, it is very easy to do. It's not that something difficult is there. It is just yes and no.
Yeah, you'll be sharing the material with us, right, ma'am? You'll be sharing the material,
kind of material
with us, like that screening material
for the class
to be done.
No, screening is in,
yes,
the app. Screening
we'll
is in the app.
Mention the class, no doubt.
Yes, you have to mention the class. Some details of the child will be asked. You have to fill the details and you have to mention the class. And the questions will be class specific. And you have to answer the questions in the form of yes and no. When the profiler is there, you have to fill the details of the child there. And in advanced screening, again, it will come in the form of yes and no. Advanced screening is basically, suppose if you are saying the child is having problem in behavior. So what exactly behavior the child is showing, that will come in the advanced screening. And for those concerns only, your plan will be shared in the intervention plan. Only you will get the plan for the concerns that you find in the child. Yes, Venkat Reddy, sir.
Yes, ma'am, please go ahead and ask your question.
Excuse me, ma'am. We have to do the screening only after finishing the 17 modules?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, then yes.
Screening
how long, like,
ma'am? For you only after you finish the 17 module course. Once you finish the 17 module course, only then screening will be available to you. And once you get access to that, you can directly open screening and start screening students.
So within how many days we have to finish the 17 modules, ma'am?
17 modules, ma'am, it is up to you. But ideally, you can finish it within 7 to 10 days. Because it's a short module course available in video format, hardly 2 to 3 minute video. So ideally, it would take hardly 7 to 10 days to finish the course.
Ma'am, the entire course is actually 6.5 hours only. When we tell 7 to 10 days, we actually mean that if you are doing half an hour to 1 hour per day, after all your work and everything, while you're traveling or while you're sitting somewhere, you want to do the course, half an hour to 1 hour is maximum. Then also you can complete within a week.
Okay, thank you.
Venkat Reddy, sir, if you have any question, please go ahead and ask. Sudharani,
there is a question in the chat box. Sikha Pandey ma'am has asked, we will make the plan or the team will provide education plan for the child. The education plan is already present in the app. Once you do the screening of the child, whatever concern when we talk about is the exactly the thing, the kind of problem you can say, but it's not actually the problem. That is why we say the concern. So when you get the concern that you are facing in the child, so for every specific concern, a plan will be shared with you within the app. So there only you can see the plan, you can read the plan, you can select the, when we say the steps of teaching, it is actually the different strategies has been mentioned over there. And these are all tested strategies. So you can select any of the strategies from there. Ma'am, we don't have any PDF for that. Everything is present in the app only.
Ma'am, one more question. Is it necessary that we do screening for the DA child only, or the academically, like the slow bloomers, we can go on?
Yes, of course you can do them, because ma'am, the children who are already identified, they have been identified. But think about the children who has not been identified, but being a teacher, you are seeing that there is some concern in the child.
Yes.
That child requires it more.
Hmm.
So please do that.
We don't find any problem with the child, but maybe because of the schooling that he has done before coming here, like primary, nursery and all that, maybe they have missed it. They were not concentrating. So without any disability, the child doesn't know any basics.
You can do
that. Such children are there in my class.
Of course you can do. You can also do the screening of the children who are showing some behavior issues on a regular basis, or you can do the screening of the child who is showing some communication gap. Communication gap, when we say, means the child is not communicating age appropriate. You know, what we expect from a 6th standard child or from a 9th standard child is going to be different. But if a 9th standard child is not communicating age appropriately, he's talking like a 5th or 6th grade child, of course we can do the screening. There must be something that can be done with the child.
Ma'am, what about the hyperactive child? I have a child, he's hyperactive.
You do it, ma'am. We have the concerns. Behavior concerns are based on that only.
Right, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Madam?
Yes, sir.
Vinay from Anandapur. KV Anandapur. And actually, yes. Apart from subject teachers, miscellaneous staff also should do this screening and all.
Subject teachers, So when we talk about the non-teaching staff, they can skip doing the screening, but they should do the course. Suppose we can't force the librarian to do the screening because they are not working with the child in the classroom setup. So what is the purpose of doing? So for them, we can.
What about art teacher? Art teacher or PT.
PT teacher, they can skip, but there is a thing. If they have found any concern, they should report that to the class teacher or other subject teacher that during their time when the child is with them, they have observed such and such thing. It will help the teacher to do the screening in a better way.
Yeah, thank you. Yes, I will okay. Do that. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ma'am. This is Anita Hemant Kumar from PM Shri KV Bolaram. I would like to know, as you said, that during intervention, you have to pick up a child. Do we need to take the consent of the parent for this case study?
No.
Don't have to for the intervention no. Even?
See, ma'am, we have planned, the plan which we have given, it is based on the classroom intervention. They are not the pull-out sessions. You are understanding the difference between the way the special educators do. I am a special educator. How we work in a school, we take the child out of the classroom, we take to the resource room, and there we do the teaching, special education teaching. But the plan which has been given to you all, it's not like that. It's just the modification that you can do in the classroom, small changes, small steps you can take within the classroom while teaching other children, because we are quite aware that you can separate time to the child. That is not possible. So this, when you go to the plan, of course, if the parents are cooperative, please, you can share with the parent that you can do such and such thing in at home also, because everything will not be possible for the parent to do at home. So you can pick up things. Okay, this can be done at home also. So you can give suggestion to the parents.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Because we are not doing any diagnosis over here. We are talking about academics. We are not talking about a special need.
Ekta ma'am is asking a question, or Ekta. So during the intervention, we can take the help of the project inclusion mentor. How can we contact with that mentor? Dear teachers, all the Hyderabad region teachers at the least, we will have a weekly mentoring session on Wednesday. The timing and the link to join for the same will be shared with you. I would be for all the Hyderabad teachers, I would be the mentor. I speak English, Telugu, and Hindi. So you can always join these mentoring sessions where you can discuss your concerns, get more educated on certain topics, and connect with your mentors on a weekly basis. So that is to answer that question. If you have any other questions to all the teachers, I would request you to join the doubt clearing sessions that happen from 4 to 5 p.m. every day. You can always put forward your questions in those doubt clearing sessions.
Ma'am, mentoring Wednesday, what are the timings? 4 p.m.?
Wednesday, ma'am, it's at 3 p.m. ideally, but yes, ma'am.
I think we can end the session now, Praveena.
Yes. So
everything will be shared in the WhatsApp group only. So you don't have to worry for that. You will be shared everything. Every detail will be shared in the WhatsApp group.
As I conclude today's session, I would like to congratulate each and every one of you who have finished the course and started your screening and intervention journey. I respect you all for the time you've taken out for today's session. May we hope to and continue to make your classes champion classes and your journey as a teacher more rewarding. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. All of you can leave the session now.